Hai dan Assalamualaikum. Hari ini saya akan menerangkan cara-cara untuk merekod video menggunakan PowerPoint presentation. Okey, so yang pertama sekali yang perlu anda buat adalah untuk membuka fail PowerPoint yang anda hendak mengajar. Okey, ataupun yang anda hendak present. Okey, lepas tu pergi kepada tab atas ni dan tekan kepada slideshow. Okay, tekan kepada slideshow and then dekat bawah button slideshow ni akan keluar ikon record slideshow. Okay, so pertama sekali untuk boleh anda record video menggunakan PowerPoint, anda perlu ada anda perlu menggunakan Windows 10 lah. Okay, so dia akan ada apps ni lah. Alright, okay, so kita tekan pada ikon tu tadi, so nampaklah muka saya kat situ. Okay, so sebab tujuan kita untuk merekod ni adalah untuk menghasilkan video pengajaran contohnya. Okay, so dekat sini dia akan ada ikon record, ikon stop dengan ikon replay. Okay, so after kita dah record tu and then bolehlah kita replay semula untuk tengok hasil video tu macam mana. Alright, so dekat bawah ni, so dia akan keluar, ni yang saya suka sebab dia akan keluar apa pen yang kita boleh guna untuk conteng. Okay, and then pemadam untuk erase apa-apa yang tersalah. And then ada highlighter lah dekat sini. So dan juga kat sini ada a few colours that anda boleh pilih untuk melakukan contingan kat situ lah. Okay, mengikut warna yang anda suka. So dekat sini akan ada ikon mic kat sini. And then ada ikon orang kat sini. And then ikon untuk apa, turn camera off. Okay, so sebab kita nak menghasilkan video pengajaran, okay, so bolehlah pilih sama ada untuk tak keluar, okay, muka kat sini. So kita tekan dekat ikon orang ni lah, so tak adalah muka keluar. Kalau untuk kita mengajar, tak bolehlah tekan mic off, so macam mana nak mengajar. Okay, so kita tekan dia balik, okay, mic, and then kalau nak keluar video, tekan orang ni balik. Okay, so keluar video muka anda dekat situ lah. Okay, so dekat sini saya ada a few slide pengajaran untuk chapter photosynthesis. So saya akan tunjuklah sedikit macam mana nak merekod menggunakan PowerPoint. Okay, so first kita akan tekan record lah. Okay, so record. So dia akan keluar ni lah, countdown. Okay, so alright class, today our chapter, we are going to look at the chapter on photosynthesis. Okay, so basically photosynthesis is the process that the plant use to convert solar energy or light energy into chemical energy. Okay, so the chemical energy produced at the end of the process is sugar, okay, or glucose. Okay, so the process of photosynthesis, it occurs in the leaves of plant. Okay, that specifically it involves the organelle chloroplasts. Okay, so leaves, okay, as you can see, it is green in color, so it is the location where photosynthesis occurs. So why is it green? Because it has many chlorophyll pigments that are located in the membranes of this thylakoid structure that are located in the chloroplast. Okay, so this is the chloroplast organelle, the organelle which is chloroplast, and inside of the chloroplast it has many thylakoids. Okay, so the thylakoids contain many pigments, okay, which is chlorophyll. And then as you can see here, so this is the structure where the carbon dioxide that enters into the leaf enters, which is through the stomata, and the byproduct of photosynthesis exit, which is oxygen. So oxygen will be released from the leaf through the stomata and will be used by other organism such as human or animals, okay, to carry out cellular respiration. Okay, so okay, so as you can see here, so this is the structure of a chloroplast. So chloroplast, it has two membranes. Okay, the outer membrane, the inner membrane, and inside here you have many thylakoids. Okay, so the thylakoids, it has membrane. Okay, it has membrane where you can find the chlorophyll pigment. So the function of the chlorophyll pigment is to absorb light energy. Okay, is to absorb light energy. So the light energy will be used during the light reaction to produce two types of molecule, which is ATP and NADPH. Okay, so these are the light. Okay, the light that will be used. Okay. Okay, so the next one, the next slide here, as you can see, the two stages of photosynthesis. So the two stages of photosynthesis here, you have the light reactions and also the Calvin cycle. So the light reaction here, it occurs in the thylakoid. Okay, so the thylakoid. So as you can see, the thylakoid here, where you can find the chlorophyll pigment, will absorb the light energy, which is in the form of photons. Okay, so the light energy is used to split water molecule, and then at the end of the light energy, it produces two types of molecule, which is ATP and also NADPH. So this ATP and NADPH molecule will be released into the stroma and used in the Calvin cycle. And the byproduct of the light reaction is oxygen. Okay, oxygen. So oxygen will be used by human to carry out cellular respiration, right? And then okay, so the ATP and NADPH will be used in the Calvin cycle. So Calvin cycle is the next stage of photosynthesis. Okay, so it is also known as the dark reaction. Okay, so during Calvin cycle, carbon dioxide will be fixed. Okay, the carbon in the carbon molecule in the carbon dioxide will be fixed, and then will be used by the Calvin cycle to produce sugar. So you cannot see sugar here, so it's just right here sugar. Okay, sugar, which is glucose. Okay, a 6 carbon molecule, right? Okay, so you have to remember that photosynthesis, it has two stages, light reaction and the Calvin cycle. So next. Okay, so that's it for our class today. So very short lecture, so to be continued next time. Okay, so bila dah habis rekod tu, kita tekan stop. Okay, and then bila dah tekan stop tu, kita boleh replay lah pada slide yang kita nak, contohnya pada slide ni. Okay, so kita boleh tekan replay. So dia akan show lah recording tu tadi. Okay, so kita tekan stop, alright, and then tekan pangkah ke atas corner atas ni, alright, and then it says here want to save your changes to photosynthesis video. So kita tekan kepada cancel dululah. Okay, cancel dulu. Okay, so cancel dulu. And then, kalau kita tengok kepada individual slide ni, contohnya, dia akan keluarlah recording untuk setiap slide. Okay, dia akan keluar recording untuk setiap slide. Okay, contohnya slide yang kedua ni. Okay, dia akan keluar untuk recording untuk slide yang kedua. So, tekan je lah play. Okay. Okay, so macam slide yang keempat ni tadi, saya tak sempat nak terangkan dia betul-betul. So, kira macam slide tu tak jadi. So, kita boleh tekan right click. Okay, tekan right click. And then tekan cut. Dan kita boleh record semula untuk slide yang kita rasa tak jadi tu tadi. Ataupun ada salah fakta. Ataupun tersasul. Okay, so kita boleh record balik untuk slide tu sahaja. So, dengan cara record slide. Okay, dengan cara record slide. So, dia akan keluar muka kita balik. And then, kalau macam ada conteng, boleh remove dulu tadi. Okay, dekat yang tadi tu. And then, record lah semula untuk slide yang tak jadi tu tadi. Okey, untuk slide tu je. Lepas tu, tekan stop and then tekan pangkah kat atas ni semula, balik semula. Okey. So, contohnya, saya tekan balik semula. Okey. Untuk recording untuk slide ni je. Okey, so the chlorophyll pigment, the pigment that are found in the thylakoids will absorb, okay, red light, okay, red light, and also blue light, and reflect green light. Okay, it reflects green light and also transmit green light. So that's why you see leaves as green in color, because the green light will not be absorbed. The green light will be reflected and transmitted. Okay, so kita boleh tekan stop and then tekan pangkah balik semula. So adalah recording yang untuk slide yang tak jadi tu tadi. Okay, so ini yang jadi. Okay, so bila dah siap hasil. Okey, contohnya kalau macam slide ni tak suka ada conteng-conteng kat sini, contohnya bolehlah padam. Okey, dengan cara tekan right click lah and then cut. Okey. Okey, so cara nak save adalah, okey, so first make sure yang raw file tu tadi, okey, tekan save as PowerPoint juga. Okey, save as PowerPoint dekat destination yang nak. Okay, save as PowerPoint and then save, okay. And then supaya boleh buka balik and edit baliklah kalau nak lakukan editing balik semula, okay. Kalau nak hasilkan video, okay, so kita pilih sebagai ini, kita pilih ni MPEG-4 ni, okay. So dia akan save dalam bentuk MP4 lah, MPEG-4 ni, okay. So dia akan save dalam bentuk video. So tekan save. Okay, tekan save. So, untuk duration video tu tadi, so dia akan ambil masa lah juga untuk record. Okay, so tunggulah dulu. Tunggu sampai video tu dah save dalam bentuk MP4. Okay, so kita tunggu jap. Okay, so dia dah habis savekan dalam bentuk MP4. So, ini hasil yang video yang dah disavekan dalam bentuk MP4, so boleh klik. Okay, so dia akan play baliklah video presentation itu tadi. Okay, so itu video dia. So boleh stop and then lah. Okay. So harap dapat membantu dalam menghasilkan video syarahan ataupun video untuk kelas ataupun video pengajaran yang terbaik lah. Okay, semoga memberi manfaat. Terima kasih.